Hi, this is Lisa LeBlanc, and you're watching Stingray Pause Play.
I'm Zach Monson. Welcome back to a very special edition of Stingray Pause Play here at the Polaris Music Prize with Canada's own Montreal's own Lisa LeBlanc. Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm doing great.
How's your day been?
It's been amazing.
What is your fondest musical childhood memory?
There are a lot, but I think the one that really comes to mind is, so I'm from a very small town in New Brunswick. After church, we all went to, my grandma's, who had a huge house, like right close to the church. And like my family, like from my dad's side, they're like 15, they're like a huge bunch and they all play music. So I remember being a kid and always being like surrounded by musicians and like my aunts and uncles and just kind of like a potluck every Sunday. And so, you know, like it was awesome. And that's kind of how I like grew up. And it was just, you know, in my blood. Yeah.
So beyond, you know, your parents' taste in music, your cousins or your uncles or your grandparents' taste in music, what was the first song that you remember hearing that was your own taste that you loved?
That's a good question. But my first CD was Train, Drops of Jupiter.
Okay. All right. Digging into some deep cuts with Lisa here. I mean, it was a good song. It was a good
Polaris
song.
Polaris Confessions. Yeah. Yeah, it's my first CD. It's not like,
I'll forgive
know,
you.
Like,
I'll forgive you.
And that's a great tune. Like,
it was a go-to karaoke track for me for a
it
while.
It was.
Yeah.
But I mean, when you think about it, it's a really good
it's
tune.
It's a good song.
Yeah.
They're
or
a
like
good
Savage Garden. You know, that's like my guilty pleasures.
You should have stuck with Train.
I should have said.
And then you shouldn't have mentioned Savage Garden.
I am
Garden.
An open book.
Maybe just turn the page, maybe. Don't have to close the book. Just turn the page maybe next time would be
okay.
Good.
But that was like my like childhood, like first kind of like remembering listening to music and like dancing on tunes. It's
Chicka
like,
Chicka Cherry Cola. So we asked the last artist in to ask you a question.
Hi, I'm Lilo Pimienta, La Babesa. And my question for you is, if you find a lamp with the genie in it, what you gonna ask him? You got 3 wishes. What's up?
I don't know.
Don't think too deep. What in this moment,
like,
right
now? Am I in a pageant right now? Like, I wish for world peace and.
I mean, world peace is an okay answer.
That would be a very good answer. So I'm not gonna say like, oh, I'd love to have like ribs every day. It's like, no, I'll say world peace.
Yeah. And you already have ribs every day, so that's fine.
Yeah, I was just in Nashville. Yeah, absolutely. That's great.
Let's talk why you want to leave Runaway Queen. Why you want to leave Runaway Queen?
I've always loved being on the road. It's always felt like home to me. And I don't like staying at the same place for too long. I just kind of get bored and restless. And I've been doing it since I was like 19. And I've been playing shows since I was 16. So, I mean, for my whole like adult life, all I've known is music and traveling. So for me, when I was writing this album, I had 6 months off. So the first part of the 6 months, I went down to the US for a 2-month road trip, which was really fun. When I came back, I stayed in Montreal for 4 months, which was the most time I've ever spent in a play, like since I'd move away from my parents' place, basically. So yeah, it was really an interesting process for me, just trying to kind of sit down, relax, and enjoy one city and kind of feel like a tourist, you know, like, and enjoy. Anyway, so that was kind of like the whole writing. It was kind of like a good resume of my last years of being like constantly on the road and always wanting to kind of be away, like, and finally you're just kind of running away.
A lot of the songs seem to be about either broken or frustrating relationships, whether it's friendship or love or... Is that something that you've carried through this album? Is that kind of a feeling that you had? And are a lot of people around you having relationship problems with friends or love, or are you just constantly heartbroken?
I think love is such a universal subject and it's so easy to write. I mean, like, you know, and like this whole record, it's like, oh my God, your relationships are so shitty. And it's like, actually, well, some of them were, they really were actually. Yeah. And, but I mean, like, what happens when you're writing a song, it's like just a picture of a moment. And you're always like, for me, I'm always writing when I'm like at a peak of an emotion or something that's really extreme or whatever. And I need to like, just like push it out somehow. Yeah. And so that's kind of what happens. And it just looks like I have like a breakup record. Yeah. And I'm like, oh, it wasn't that bad. Like, yeah. Or like, I mean, there's like two or three songs that are for like one dude. Yeah. So, you know, like, it's not like I'm constantly being heartbroken.
Okay, good. I'm glad to hear it.
Thank you very much.
I'm very happy to hear that.
I'm happy to hear it too. I wouldn't want to, no.
The banjo is showcased quite highly on this album. Where does this love of banjo come from? And the song Ace of Spades, you know, it's like, it's a pretty heavy song. And I've never heard such a heavy track feature the banjo. So right. where does this love? I mean, it's like heavy rock, and then the banjo comes in and just kills it. But where does that love come from?
When I moved out of New Brunswick and moved to Quebec for the first time to do like to be in Granby for a year, I started really missing New Brunswick, and that's when I started kind of listening for fun, like to bluegrass. And I bought a banjo, and I was like, but I mean, I was just kind of bored to like play rhythm guitar in jams because 12 other guitarists were much better than me.
Right.
And I was like, whatever, who cares? Like playing the same chords. So I was like, well, banjo could be cool because I can, you know, like finger pick and do stuff that's more rhythmic, but at least add something to the jam. So anyway, like this whole thing, I'm now a huge bluegrass fan and an old time fan. And it's just kind of become like that mix of banjo, which I find is a very interesting instrument, and it's very particular.
Yeah.
And it stands out, and I feel like I can, you know, there's things that I can express on a banjo that are different than on the guitar, and it just really brings me in. Banjo is not one of those
instruments that's ever hidden in the background of a track.
No.
If there's banjo, there's banjo.
It's not a subtle instrument, not in any way. Anyway, so that's a bit of the story of like my relationship with the banjo, and now I love it. I mean, I play it more than I do guitar. That's what I lug with me all the time if I'm traveling, and it's just been kind of like that, a good conversation starter actually, to have a banjo on your back when you're traveling, you know.
Well, I liked that contrast of that bluegrassy banjo and just that hard track. I thought it really interesting, and it worked so beautifully.
Thank you
so much for chatting with me.
Thanks,
I really,
so much.
Really appreciate
this was
it.
A lot of fun.
You can hear Lisa LeBlanc on, here we go, Stingray Music's Canadian Indie Channel, Canadiana Channel, Franco Attitude Channel, Franco Country, Franco Pop, and of course all over Stingray Music's Vibes channels, available now on our mobile app and our web player. Don't forget to share this video, leave us a comment, thumbs up, and subscribe to keep up to date with all the newest episodes of Stingray Pause Play. See you next time, guys.